My name's Charlie Duke. I was fortunate to have been an Apollo astronaut. We had 9 missions to the moon. I was fortunate to work on 5 of those missions. I was twice in mission control, a backup crew on Apollo 13, Apollo 17, flew to the moon on Apollo 16, and was the 10th man to step foot onto the moon.
First, I believe that this nation should commit itself to achieving the goal, before this decade is out, of landing a man on the moon and returning him safely to the earth.
When he made the announcement, I shook my head. There's no way. You know, we got 15 minutes in space with Alan Shepard's flight, and he's committing us to the moon. What a bold statement. I thought it was incredulous. But the country pitched in. Next year, I got to MIT, and MIT was building the Apollo Guidance and Navigation System, and I got to work on it. And I met some astronauts, and through that work, and I'd never seen anybody so enthusiastic and so positive that we were going to do this. And so I began to get that excitement. Maybe I could do that job. And so that was the really 62, 64 time frame when I was at MIT was when I really got excited that, yeah, we're going to pull this off. We're going to do this. The war, no question, was ripping us apart. But the space program was pulling us together. I saw the Apollo with the hundreds of thousands of people involved in the program and the excitement that we're in a race. We're still in a Cold War, but we're in the hot war in Vietnam. But we're going to win this Cold War. I went around the country speaking back in those days. I found a lot of togetherness, if you will. And the kids, the adults, everybody was excited about it. And we're going to do something that's never been done before. So it did pull the country together. Astronauts and the accomplishments of the space program are still respected. I think the political climate did change. Why are we spending so much money on the moon? And my answer to that was, we didn't spend a dime on the moon. It was all spent in the United States of America. We had 400,000 people. And so a lot of people benefited from the technology that was developed in the space program, and there have been many studies showing that the rate of return on our investment has been significant from the space program in the space race, if you will. I'm a big proponent of technology, and I see the benefits that technology has brought to us and brought the world together. I just got back from India. The people on the street in India, everybody, they might be poor, but they got a cell phone, and they can communicate, and they can touch things that they'd never able to do, you know, 40 years ago. The fact that the technology that we developed was state of the art, it was crude compared to what we have today, but it was the best we had. People are using technology for advancements in products and economies and all of those kind of things that is going to be very beneficial, can pay great dividends to us as a society. I don't see any conflict. Science is based on immutable laws, and the laws of the universe were put into effect by a designer. I'll call him God. The question of science to faith or science to religion is really a question, in my mind, of evolution or creation. Evolution is just as faith-based as as creation is faith-based. And creation is just as scientific as evolution. And so you never can prove either one scientifically, so it's a matter of belief. What do I believe? And I think the evidence now, in my view, points more towards that there's a designer of the universe is too orderly, that's just the thought that things just happen by accident is beyond my comprehension these days. NASA was all of Big Bang and all of that stuff, it just happened. A couple of my astronaut buddies still hold to that view. We had a discussion last night, as a matter of fact, on this very subject. We can disagree, but still be buddies. I try to get the kids to take the hard courses. Challenge yourself in school. Don't just try to drift through school, you know. You never know what's going to happen in your life. I mean, when I was a kid, there wasn't any space program. But I kept my view wide, and I had a sort of a plan that I wanted. The only thing I knew is I wanted to be a pilot. And so I became a pilot, and then all of a sudden I was in flight school and Sputnik went up, you know, and well, wow, there's a new way to fly. We go into space maybe. And so I just kept going, and one step at a time. And so I try to encourage kids, not only my grandkids, but the kids I get to speak to. I'm very active with the Astronaut Scholarship Foundation, and We give scholarships to deserving kids all over the country. And it's good to see the kids being challenged today and the interest in the space program. When I applied for NASA, there were 3,500 applications, all men back in those days. In 2017, NASA had 18,000 applications for the astronaut program. So the interest is there, you know, and the desire to explore in this younger generations is all there. It's very exciting to me. It's a different generation. Space is more accepted, I guess you will. So no, I don't see mounting a mission to Mars is creating the same kind of environment that we had in Apollo. But that's aviation. You know, you look at, my dad was born in 1907, 4 years after the Wright brothers. In 60 years, he watched his son go to the moon. He could hardly believe it. My five-year-old son, Tom, is now an adult, of course. No big deal, you know. Everybody in the neighborhood's going to the moon. You know, next door neighbor went to the moon. Neil Armstrong went to the moon. He lives right behind us. And, you know, Tom Stafford went to the moon, and Frank Borman went to the moon. Everybody in the neighborhood went to the moon. And so it was well accepted. And so I see that evolution of space, not from the drama of it, but just the fact that this is going to happen. I think that's the human spirit, is to go out and explore and discover, and that's the inquisitive nature I think we all have within us, and we channel that in different directions. But space is certainly a big part of it, and a trip to Mars, I think we will eventually get there, and I might not be alive, but by then, but this is going to be a challenge, and I think a human species is going to accept that challenge, see what's out there.